Welcome to another video about TMS Web Core. Today I would like to introduce a new feature, automatic routing or automatic routing, whichever pronunciation you prefer. First, let's talk about the reason why we need routing in the first place. The reason is spa. No, not that kind of spa, even though it looks rather cozy. No, I'm talking about single page applications. Every form or page in your TMS Web Core application has the same URL on the web server. Every TMS Web Core application creates the main form and uses the browser's canvas to draw each and every form. If you open a second or third form, they're drawn on top of each other. These kinds of web applications work completely differently from the traditional ones that have a different URL for each and every page they show. However, this is no longer a downside. Automatic routing will allow you to navigate to any form using different URLs. You only need to implement these three simple steps, and you don't do these in order, as you'll see right away. I'll explain each and every step in great detail looking at a code example, but let's look at the steps first. First, register each form. Second, enable routing inside of the application. Obviously, you only need to do this once. You don't have to enable routing multiple times. And then, the most important one, do not close your forms if you want to navigate back. Use the new go back functionality instead. Let's look at the basic example that is bundled with TMS Web Core. It's called TMS Web _routing, and you find it in the basic demo folder. First, let's look how the application works. This looks like a multi-form application like any other. The main form, Form 1, is being shown, and we can click Open Form 1 to open the second form. However, we can click Go Back, and then we go back to Form Number 1. We can open Form 3, we can go back, and so on. The magic is that inside of the URL, we now get specifiers for the different forms inside of the application. And best of all, let's say I want to go to Form 2, I can edit the URL and go directly to Form 2. Of course, you can customize what this URL name is going to be. You can say, hey, this is the customer's invoices inside of your accounting web application, for example. So you no longer have to redirect your customers only to the main page, and then they have to navigate to the specific form themselves. Now you can create URLs to one specific form inside of your application. Let's look at the source code. First, I said each form has to be registered. You'll find this in the initialization section of each form. Here is the registration for Form 1, register class tform1. Remember, this is the class type, not the name of the instance. So if the form is of type tform1, you have to register the class tform1. And then unit 2 has form2, you find register class tform2, unit 3 tform3, and unit 4 register class tform4. Second, enable it. And you enable it in the application. That means you need to open the application source by right-clicking on the TMS Web Core project and then find View Source. Alternatively, you can also select the project and press Ctrl V. There, you have to add in front of the creation of the main form, if not application.root. Meaning, if the user did not specify a special root, open the main form. That's all that does. And that is actually all you need to do to enable automatic routing in your TMS Web Core application. The final third step is even easier. The main form, of course, doesn't go back anywhere, so that is not even a consideration there. However, for the other forms 2, 3, and 4, we have to implement the go back functionality. Opening form number 2, looking at the designer, the go back implementation is application.goback. The T application class has been extended with the go back method, and that's all you need to call using the singleton application.goback. The same in form number 3, and also number 4. That's it. That's all it takes to implement automatic routing in TMS Web Core. The second example adds more web design into the mix. So you open the project, go to basics, and then admin routing is the example that we're looking for. We're not going to look at the source code of this demo. This is just to show that it works with well-designed, more complex applications and user interfaces just as well. We're in the dashboard, I click on docs, and the URL also goes to docs. I go to settings, and now I can also add or change the URL myself, going to docs, and I go to the docs page directly. So navigation has become much, much easier to implement with TMS Web Core. For everything about TMS Web Core, go to web.tmssoftware.com. Be sure to subscribe to the channel TMS Software TV. I hope to see you soon. Take care.